Hey fellow tennis nerds, I hope all is well. Today I wanted to talk about the Yonex V-Core 95 series of rackets. I'm not going to go back to the V-Core 95D, but I can mention that briefly. That's the racket that Stan Wawrinka uses under various paint jobs. It's also a nice racket, but it needs more weight probably than any of these rackets that came after in the 95 scrimmage category. The reason I wanted to talk about the Yonex 95 series is that I just did a trade with a guy I helped with a Tennis Nerd consultation. And he wanted to try the Head Pro Tour, of which I had a couple, and I wanted to try the SV95, of which he had a couple. So we did a trade. I can really recommend doing that. There are a bunch of forums. There's a Tennis Nerd Facebook group, which is meant to be for these kind of things. So you can get in touch with racket people, and maybe you have a racket you don't like and you want to try another racket, you can find a switcheroo there. So I think that's a good solution. I've done that loads in the past, the reason I've been able to try a bunch of rackets. So you buy, sell, trade. I've never tried a V-Core SV95, so it was a little bit surprising how good it looks in up close with the glossy paint job. It definitely appeals more to me than the rackets that came thereafter. Slightly stiffer, has a bit more raw feel than the following version. A bit more metallic, a bit more kind of heavy, although the swing weight is the same. When I measure them, it's around 316, both of them, which is pretty low, but they are rackets that usually need a little bit of weight. And it was the same with the other V-Core from the 2021, this year's V-Core edition, that also had a swing weight of 315 around. And I've strung them with Solinka Hyper G Soft 1.20 gauge at the same tension, around 52 pounds, so I can compare them. And playing with this one for the first time was a very positive experience in many ways. I might never be able to switch to a V-Core 95 due to my preference of a more old school head shape. The isometric head shape is not super extreme, but it still kind of irks me somewhat when swinging the racket. That's very personal and nothing to take seriously if you don't feel that at all. I understand 100%. So this racket is stiffer. You get a little bit more vibrations. I wouldn't say it's harsh, but I would, you know, pay attention to it if you have arm issues. Looks definitely better in my opinion, especially with the glossy paint. If I can kind of compare it to something, is that when you play with the first edition of the Babolat Aero Pro Drive, it was called then, and that has that raw feel that Rafa fell in love with and he's been using it ever since. A little bit more control from the string bed, a little bit more connected to the ball. It's not as plastic feeling as some of the other Aero Pro Drives, Pure Aeros. So that's kind of feels similar in a respect. Like this one feels like I'm more connected to this frame than I am with this one. I was ready to kind of fall in love again with this frame. Couldn't quite get used to it. There's something that I don't feel 100% happy with in the string bed. And tennis rackets, they're so personal. It's such a personal decision what tennis racket you play with. That's why I try to kind of give all aspects of tennis rackets in my reviews, and I can't say that one racket is garbage and one racket is great. There's usually someone out there that will like a racket, and there's a bunch of other people that won't like that racket. That's how it is. And I just try to describe what the racket gives you and what kind of player type, player level that a racket can suit. That's kind of why I'm trying to do this, because I know like there's rackets that I kind of hated that some players I know who hit the ball really well love, and vice versa. I really believe that this racket suits me a bit better than the upcoming versions. So this one feels a bit more raw, a bit more direct in the string bed, a little bit stiffer. I don't mind it because it's not too stiff. This one, it feels a little bit too flexible perhaps. It's good for the arm friendliness, but it feels a little bit too flexible at times. Like you're not 100% sure what's going on with in the string bed. Feels a little bit inconsistent at times. I get a bit of a ball flight on my shots. Yes, I don't have the best technique and so on, but I feel like it's sailing, the ball is sailing a little bit at times, which I don't feel the same with this one. So that would be my opinion about that. The new version is much more muted. You don't feel connected to the ball at all, in my opinion. I know a lot of players love that racket. I did like it in many ways because it was easy to use. You got a lot of free power and spin for a 95 square inch racket. Just impressive performance in that sense. The guy I hit with, he was just taken by it, although he really likes old school frames as well, but he was just taken by that racket. So another example of how personal it is. For me, of all the V-Cores, I felt most connected to the SV now, and I could really see why some players swear by it. I'm not sure if this is what Shapovalov uses. I would guess so. I think they created it for him and they based it on the 6195 that he was using. Changed the string pattern a little bit. He gets a bit more spin with his shots with the 1620 pattern. The thickness of the beam is similar. I would say this is 22 millimeters, similar and exactly the same as the 6195. 95 square inch head size, a bit more forgiveness from the isometric head shape. I could see why he could easily switch to this with some customization. So whether he uses a different layup for a pro stock layup, I cannot know. But I don't think Yonex makes a lot of layup configurations for their pros. So I would say that he actually uses this one and it was made to suit his taste. He's a good ambassador for this frame, fun player to watch, explosive power of both wings, like that jumping one-handed backhand that I can't do myself, of course. The SV95 kind of sailed up, became my favorite. V-Core 95, is it better than the V-Core 95D? Not sure. That's one of my favorite frames, but it's almost impossible to find. One of my favorite Yonex frames, but it needed a bunch of lead tape, so it gets quite heavy, like Stand the Man. He adds it up to kind of 370 grams, which is a bit crazy, but you need to kind of get it up to 350 for it to feel really good. That one is a little bit, it's even rawer than this one. You can really see the way Yonex has tried to address different things with a racket line. So they started with the V-Core 95D. They got a really raw racket that has a lot of good things about it, similar to this, like with the spin from the 1620 pattern, while still retaining some control, but it had some stability issues in stock form. It wasn't really kind of ready to just be played like that. It needed weight at 3 and 9. And so it wasn't maybe a finished racket in that sense. And then this one, the SV, it feels a lot more finished, a bit more refined than the V-Core 95D, but still quite stiff, and still it has that raw feel. Might not be everyone's cup of tea. So they tried to refine it even more. They lowered the stiffness. They went to a really flexy 62 with strings. I don't know why they stopped with the glossy paint, because this one looks pretty cheap now when I look at it compared to this one. It's such a different appearance to me. So they went this way, which is feels like it's a lot nicer on impact in some respects. It's harder to really feel the sweet spot with this one, I find it a little bit erratic, even compared to this one. And then they went and a little bit back to the stiffer layup, but with a lot more dampening with the new one. So they try to make it like really easy to like and get used to in stock form. I felt like they went too far with the dampening. That's my opinion. It's a personal feel, as I said. But in stock form, it's probably a better playing racket than this one. In the end, I said when I played this that I prefer this one, and in the feel I do, but probably I'm playing worse with this one. I found that it was harder to get back into the groove with after really enjoying it for a couple of sessions. So you need to try rackets a bit more to really find out their identity and compare them and see what they do compared to other rackets. I would just prefer if this frame was a bit more direct in its response, and I think then it would have been perfect. They went a bit far with dampening in the new one. I hope you find some of this interesting, and if you do, please click like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Please tell your tennis friends if you haven't already done so. And if you need help finding the perfect racket for your game, check out the Tennis Nerd consultation on tennisnerd.net. I will give you a few different options. with string suggestions and so on, so you have an idea based on your game, based on what you kind of tell me in the consultation form, and we'll try to find a way to get to the right racket for you. So that's always fun, and I've got a lot of good response from it, 85 five-star reviews and counting. If you want more content like this, there's a lot more on Patreon, patreon.com/tennisnerd, where you subscribe for a small fee, $2 to $5, and you get loads of content every month. Another way to support Tennis Nerd is to buy something from one of our affiliates. I put the links in the description below. Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, Tennis Only is where you can buy tennis gear, and I get a tiny commission that can help me sustain all the work and all the stuff I put into Tennis Nerd. So much appreciated if you do that. Well, that's all for this video. Have a nice day, and don't forget to play some tennis.